Okay, so in this video and the next few videos, we're actually going to apply what we learned about the discrete-time Fourier transform. The previous video actually derived an expression for the discrete-time Fourier transform of a discrete-time signal. In these four examples right here, we're actually going to use that equation to compute the DTFT for very specific signals. What we're going to do is we're going to start off with a really simple signal, basically the simplest signal you can deal with, one that is zero for every single time instant except for one value. So we're going to find the DTFT of a unit impulse. Remember, the unit impulse is zero everywhere, but it's one at time zero. So we'll go ahead and work that example in this video, and then in the subsequent videos, we'll kind of build up the complexity of the signals we're analyzing, and the examples will get a little bit more challenging in terms of the mathematics we have to do. All right, but for now, let's start off with the DTFT of a unit impulse. So we're going to work with the signal x of k equals delta of k. And what we're going to do is we're going to find the DTFT of this signal. So again, just as a reminder what the unit impulse signal is, it is zero for all time, except for at time zero, it has a value of one. So that is the discrete time signal we're going to work with. And what we want to compute is x of capital omega. That's the notation we introduced in the last video. This means the DTFT of x of k. Capital omega is our frequency variable, and the units of that are in radians per sample. So let's just go ahead and write down, first of all, the definition of the DTFT. Remember, this was the equation we had last time. It's a sum from minus infinity to infinity of the signal that we're trying to take the transform of projected onto e to the minus j omega k. So that is what I want to take the DTFT of in terms of this, the core definition. For this particular example, we're told that our signal x of k is the impulse signal delta of k. So I've gone ahead and algebraically substituted in that signal. You can see what's going to happen here now in this summation because of the fact that I'm working with the signal delta of k. That signal is off for essentially all time. So as I do this sum from minus infinity to infinity, most of the time this signal is zero. So it's zero times e to the j this, zero times. So almost every single term in this infinite summation is zero. The only term that is not zero is the term of k equals zero. At k equals zero, this is what I get for my term in the summation. I replace all the k's with k equals zero. So I have delta of zero times e to the minus j omega zero. Obviously, our signal delta is equal to one at time zero, so I can replace a one there. And then e to the zero is always one, so I'll also get a one there. One times one is one, so that is the DTFT of the unit impulse. X of omega is actually equal to 1 for all omega. So that symbol right there, if you're not familiar with it, is for all. So, kind of an interesting example. If I have a unit impulse, which is an impulse in time, I actually get a constant, a flat value of 1 in the frequency domain. Just for the heck of it, let's go ahead and compute the amplitude spectrum and phase spectrum. This is actually real valued for all omega, so it's not complex, so we don't have to break it down into two components, but it's still kind of a common thing to do that. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's compute the amplitude response of the signal by computing the magnitude of this. Well, the magnitude of 1 is just 1, so that's pretty easy. So it's equal to 1 for all frequency. Similarly, if we compute the phase spectrum of the signal, what is the angle of this complex quantity as a function of omega? Well, it's not complex, and it's not even a function of omega, it's just this constant. The angle of a real valued constant is just zero. So when I plot the phase spectrum of the signal, it's just equal to zero for all frequency. All right, so that is this example. We actually have derived now this pair. Delta of k in time is one in frequency. And we're actually going to see that, you know, fairly regularly. That's one of those things you end up just kind of memorizing in a signals and systems class. An impulse in time is a constant in the frequency domain. So that wraps up this example. Thanks for watching. In the next video, we'll go ahead and work with a slightly more complicated signal, and we'll find the DTFT of that simple sequence.